मीन्स ऑल द थिंग्स दे वेर ट्रेडिंग, व्हाट दे वेर ट्रेडिंग, मसलिन, इंडिगो, ब्लैक पेपर एक्सेट्रा, दे वेर ट्रेडिंग. हुम दे वेर ट्रेडिंग? दे वेर ट्रेडिंग टू यूरोप. बट व्हाट हैपन्स इन बिटवीन? कॉन्स्टेंटिनोपल वॉज कमिंग. इन बिटवीन व्हाट इट वॉज कमिंग? कॉन्स्टेंटिनोपल. इट वॉज द नेम ऑफ द सेंटर. सो बाई टर्किश मुस्लिम, बाई हुम? टर्किश मुस्लिम, बाई टर्किश मुस्लिम इन 1453 एडी. विच एडी? 1453 एडी. बाई टर्किश मुस्लिम इन 1453 एडी ही स्टॉप लैंड रूट बिटवीन, ही स्टॉप लैंड रूट बिटवीन इंडिया एंड यूरोप. इंडिया एंड यूरोप, गॉट इट बॉयज?
Yes,
बेस्ट
ma'am,
ऑफ
yeah.
लैंड रूट बिटवीन इंडिया एंड यूरोप. सो
Yes,
व्हाट
ma'am.
इज द
Yes, ma'am.
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, वी वेर एज वी वेर इकोनॉमिकली प्रॉस्पेरिटी, ऑल द थिंग्स वी वेर गुड. सो व्हाट हैपन्स? ट्रेड बिटवीन इंडिया एंड यूरोप वॉज स्टार्टेड. एज वॉट वी वेर ट्रेडिंग? वी वेर ट्रेडिंग मसलिन क्लोथ, इंडिगो, ब्लैक पेपर एक्सेट्रा. ओके, सो इन बिटवीन कॉन्स्टेंटिनोपल, बाय कॉन्स्टेंटिनोपल टर्किश मुस्लिम हैज स्टॉप लैंड एंड सी रोड बिटवीन इंडिया एंड यूरोप इन विच ईयर? इन 1453 एडी. सो नाउ वी हैव बीन स्टार्टेड फाइंडिंग अ न्यू सी रोड. सो अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज डिस्कवरी ऑफ अ न्यू सी रोड. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज डिस्कवरी ऑफ न्यू सी रूट इन इंडिया. ओके, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज डिस्कवरी ऑफ न्यू सी रूट इन इंडिया. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू नोट डाउन दिस, यू कैन नोट इट डाउन. आर यू नोटिंग?
We can take a screenshot.
यस यू कैन. सो इट विल बी इजियर फॉर टू लर्न. Got it?
Yes, ma'am, yes.
Ma'am, what we have to do?
If you want to note down this topic, you can note it down in your book. Otherwise, take a screenshot. You can see it clearly, everything?
Yes,
yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. Again, just now you came better, so again I am explaining. We have been started with introduction, revision
ma'am,
of
I know
introduction.
All these things.
All you are knowing? Okay. Then
yes.
If you want to note it down, it will be easier for you to learn the question answers. So I am
Yes,
giving
ma'am.
you points. So if you want to note down, you can note it down. Otherwise, I will be moving to the next topic.
Ma'am, next topic for them.
Okay. Now, this after this land route and sea route, both have stopped. Now we will be discovering a new sea route. Next topic is discovery of a new sea route to India. Got it? Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
If you want to note down, note it down with me. Discovery of a new sea route to India. So as trading is stopped, so our economic level will also be stopped. So we will be finding a new sea route. So first, who will come first with the inspiration and encouragement? With the inspiration and encouragement and economic help of Portuguese kings. Portuguese King Prince Henry. Who is the first? Who was there? Prince Henry. Who was there? Prince Henry. First, who came with the inspiration and economically? A Portuguese King Prince Henry has started discovering a new sea route, but he can't find out. So next came Bartholomew's Dias. Who will tell me? Who came? Bartholomew Dias.
Dias.
Bartholomew Dias came. As Prince Henry can't find out, so next came Bartholomew Dias. as he was the first explorer. He was also a Portuguese sailor to find a route, and he was a first sailor, and he sailed. Where he sailed from south tip. From where he started, south tip of Africa. From where he started, south tip of Africa. But he also failed, and he only reached to win Cape of Good Hope. Where he reached? Cape of
Good Hope.
Good Hope. So it is known as a Cape of Good Hope. So first came Portuguese Queen Prince Henry. He can't find out. So next came Bartholomew Dias. He started from south tip of Africa and reached to Cape of Good Hope. So it is known as Cape of Good Hope. Both of them were filled now. Now third came Columbus. Third who came? Columbus.
Columbus.
These both are Portugal sailors. These both are Portugal sailors. But Columbus, take a screenshot if you want, or otherwise note it down fast. Afterwards I move ahead. Taken?
Yeah.
All the boys.
Yeah.
Arsh, Mohammad Adbas, Hamza.
Ma'am, I know this also.
Okay, so next came Columbus. Who came? Christopher Columbus. He was an Italian sailor. Next who came? Christopher. Columbus. He was an Italian sailor. So he reached to an island. Where he reached? He first started sailing from westwards. So he started from left side, okay, westwards to reach India. But he reached only to an island that is of an Atlantic Ocean. Which island he reached? Atlantic Ocean island, okay. So he thought that he has reached to India, but he has not reached. So it was known as West Indies. That island was known as?
West Indies.
West Indies. After that, as he reached to the island of West Indies, he thought that instead of reaching India, he went to America. So he was not realizing that he was thinking that I am in India. But he didn't reach. So next came Amerigo Vespucci. Amerigo Vespucci, fourth is Amerigo Vespucci. He has given a new land name, that is America. What he has given? A name? America to a new land. Okay. Then last is Vasco da Gama. Last is Vasco da Gama. Should I rub this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So last is Vasco da Gama. He was also a Portugal sailor. Vasco da Gama. He is a Portugal sailor. So now what happens? Finally, he started from the tip of South Africa. From where he started? From the tip of South Africa and reached to Calicut. Where he reached? Calicut. He started from the tip of South Africa and he finally reached in Calicut of west of India. And with the permission of King Zamorion, he found a new sea route in 1498 AD. What he found out? A new sea route that is in 1498 AD. Got it? So now trading between India and Europe, the business between India and Europe was started. Got it? This much how a new discovery sea route started.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay? What were the attempts? Understood? Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now we will be starting with the new topic. Yesterday I have given you a brief introduction, that is arrival of Europeans in India. Arrival of Europeans in India. So first of all, who came in India? Whose mic is unmuted?
Portuguese
people came. So, arrival of Europeans in India, a new topic. These are the revision we are doing, these topics. So first came Portuguese people. Who came? A Portugal sailor, Vasco da Gama. With whose permission? King Zamorian permission. He entered into Calicut. Where he entered?
West coast of India.
He entered to Calicut in west coast of India with the permission of King Zamorian. As Portuguese, as Dutch people, Danish people see that whose mic is unmuted? Mute your mic, Hamza. As these people, as Danish people, Dutch people, they are saying that Portuguese people are too much succeed in India. So second came Dutch from who will tell? I have told you yesterday. Dutch from Holland.
And Danish from Denmark.
Danish from Denmark. So this way, if you will be remembering, you will be understanding the topics also.
Yes.
And it will be easier for you to learn also. Okay. So first came Portuguese people with the Portuguese sailor Vasco da Gama, with the permission of King Zamorian in Calicut, west coast of India. After this, Dutch people are saying that from 100 of years, the Portuguese people are succeeding. So came Dutch from Holland and Danish people from Denmark. Clear? And Dutch people has conquered which places? Diu, Daman, Goa, Cochin. All these places were under the control of which people? That is Dutch people. Which? That is Goa,
Diu,
Daman, Cochin. These were under the rule of whom? Under the rule of Dutch people.
Dutch.
And then came for trading Danish people from Denmark. Clear this much?
Yes.
Clear? After this, now who will be arriving? British people are arriving in India. Whose arrival is coming now? British people. So as this, all these people are seeing, now comes British people or England people. Okay. Third is arrival of Britishers. So how Britishers are entering in India? With the permission of Queen Elizabeth. Whose permission?
Elizabeth.
In which year? That is in 1600 AD. Which year? 1600
AD.
Britishers people wanted to establish a trade named East India Company. Which company?
East India Company.
Yeah, company. In which, per whose permission? Queen Elizabeth permission in 1600 AD. But Portuguese people has opposed. But who has opposed? Portuguese people has opposed. Then too, they wanted to open the trade center. So they have taken Mughal Emperor Mughal Emperor, King Jahangir, who has given King
Jahangir
in 1613 AD. British people got permission in 1613 AD by Mughal Emperor King Jahangir. So they have opened a trade center in Surat in Kochi. Where they have opened trade center? Surat
in Kochi.
Kochi.
What is?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, what is the full form of AD?
No, beta. It's a place name. Which is located in Surat.
No, ma'am. I am asking what is the full form of AD? 1600 AD.
Yes, that AD I have told you. Now you find out and tell me.
Century.
What?
Century, 100 years. You say na?
Century, that is. He is asking the full form of AD.
AD.
That I told you in 8th standard in class, if you remember it. Can you find it and tell me? I will tell you afterwards.
Okay, ma'am. Aaj ka homework ye rakhte.
Haan, homework ye nahi hai. Today's homework is arrival of Europeans in India.
Alala.
In advance, I am telling you.
Allah itte search karna ek hai.
Next, how Britishers came with the permission of King Elizabeth in 1600 AD. They wanted to open which company? East India Company. But Portuguese people has opposed it. So they got a permission from whom? That is Mughal Emperor King Jahangir. So they have, in 1613 AD, they have opened a trade center of East India Company in Surat in Kochi. This much clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Then again, they have opened trade center in Surat, where they have opened Surat, Ahmedabad, and Surat, Ahmedabad, and Bharuch. At three places, they have opened trade center and main headquarter. Where was the main headquarter? In Mumbai. Where they have opened headquarter? In
Mumbai.
In which AD you are knowing? In 16. Are you knowing in which AD?
16.
Yesterday only I am. Not knowing, yesterday only I have told you. Are you knowing or I have to tell you? First tell me.
No,
yes,
no,
or
no,
no.
1617 AD.
In which AD?
1617 AD.
They have opened trade center headquarter in Mumbai. Okay, this much clear? The story?
First bit.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So, as Marathas were supporting too much, Britishers people were in danger. British people were in danger. So they went to which part? They went to the part that is South and East India. After opening the trade center in Surat, Bharuch, Ahmedabad and Mumbai, Marathas people were full forcing them. So Britishers people were in danger. So they opened trade center. They went to South and East India. Where they went? South and East India. So they opened trade in trade center over there now in Machilipatnam. As they were in danger, now where they went? South, East part they went. So where they opened trade center? Trade center in Machilipatnam in Andhra Pradesh, Machilipatnam in Andhra Pradesh, St. George in Chennai, Fort William in Kolkata. Where they have opened?
Machilipatnam in Andhra Pradesh, St. George in Chennai,
एपी मीन्स आंध्र प्रदेश यू विल अंडरस्टैंड नो
यस मैम
सेंट जॉर्ज इन चेन्नई एंड लास्ट इन कोलकाता वेयर इट इज
फोर्ट विलियम इन कोलकाता
फोर्ट विलियम इन
कोलकाता
कोलकाता सो दे ओपन ट्रेड सेंटर In which AD, that is in 1687, where in 1687 AD, clear this much, this way,
yes, ma'am.
Britishers, this way, Britishers arrived in India, got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
For Portuguese, then, Portuguese, then, Dutch,
Dutch then Danish, Denmark, then British.
Yes. Now comes arrival of the French. Now comes arrival of the French. How French people entered into India. At that time, who is living also, you can, I am telling you with that. This was the revision till yesterday. Now comes arrival of the French. Arrival of the French. Got it?
French. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Bus, bus. So, as French people are come after seeing to the Britishers as they are succeeding, now coming French people. They are establishing which company? French East India Company. Which company?
French East India Company.
French. East India Company. India so Britishers, company. Britishers has opened which company? East India Company. Now, French East India Company. So now France people are coming. Okay, so they are opening French East India Company with whom? With Britishers and Dutch people. With whom? Britishers.
And Dutch people
or that companies, okay? So what happened? French East India Company opened the trade in 1688 AD. Which AD? 1688 AD. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
So yes, ma'am. After Britishers, arrival of France people, arrival of French people, they are opening French East India Company in 1688 AD with Britishers and Dutch. Got it this much? So where they have opened their trade centers? They have opened their trade centers in Mahi. Where they are opening? Mahi, Karikal, Pondicherry, Chandranagar and Machilipattam. So Southeast India only they are opening. Where they are opening? Mahi, Karikal, Pondicherry, Machilipattam and Chandranagar.
Chandranagar.
Okay? So they are opening trade center in Mahi, Karikal,
Pondicherry,
Chandranagar,
Machilipattam.
Sorry.
Ma'am.
With whom they are opening? With Britishers
and Dutch
people.
Dutch.
Got it? Clear how yes, they were ma'am. Arrived in India?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am.
Yes.
The yes, French yes. French was arrived in 1668. You have written 1688.
I have written 1688.
Yes,
so it's my mistake. 1668 AD. Got it?
Yes,
ma'am.
Got it? So after,
yes, ma'am.
After English and French people are coming in India, what happened now? Now there will be ruling over India. So they have started ruling. This French people came to Mahi, Karikal, Pondicherry. Yes. Dutch people were in Goa, Daman. Yes. The Goa, Diu, Daman, Cochin and at that part. So they were ruling over there. So they have started ruling in union territories. So between 1746 and 1763? Which year? 1746 and 1763 AD. Karnataka people, the people, those who were living in Karnataka, were having three wars. How many wars? Three wars. Between the French East India Company and the British East India Company. Karnataka wars were started between French East India Company and British East India Company. Yes? As they have started spreading their ruling over all the parts of India. Yes? First came Portuguese. They have been succeeded for 100 of years. At that time, when French East India Company entered to the India, Portuguese people were left. Portuguese people left over there. They left and went to their Portuguese. Okay? But what happens as they were trading, French India, East India Company, British and Dutch, they were trading together. So now in 1746 and 1763 AD, three Karnataka wars were happened. How many wars? Three Karnataka wars. In that, French East India Company lost. Which people lost? French people lost. But British East India Company's power was too much in India. Who lost? French East India Company lost. But British East India Company make it easy to rule over India. Okay? Yes, and sir. At that time, Portuguese people left India. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So now comes Battle of Plassey and Battle of Buxar. What it is coming? Battle of Plassey and Battle of Buxar. It is one type of war only. So in 1746 and 1763 AD, which three wars were happened? That is Karnataka wars between French and British. At that time, French people lost their power, British people have spread out their powers. Yes? So, at that time only, who left? Portuguese people left Diu, Daman, Goa territories and went to their own country. Clear about that?
Yes, ma'am.
So now comes Battle of Plassey. Now comes Battle of
Plassey.
This you have studied in, I think so, 8th standard, chapter number 1.
Ah, ma'am.
In semester 1.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. This
chapter number 1 notes kare aap to.
Today I will be sending 3 notes. 3 topics notes. You complete it in your file book.
Okay.
Yes, I am seeing all the things. From today I will be starting with your homework. So I will be noting down that who are doing properly. So start completing this three topics by Monday. Okay? Yes, I will be sending you PDF. This is just for your understanding part. If I am only sharing your screen and showing you, then you can understand it.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes.
So now Battle of Plassey. Now next is Battle of Plassey.
Battle of what mean Battle of
Plassey?
इसका मतलब क्या?
It's one type of war.
क्या? Battle का नाम है. Name of a battle.
Fighting.
Battle का नहीं Plassey का.
It's a place
name. Plassey. Plassey is नाम है. Name
no,
है.
Okay. So in which AD? In 1756 AD. Which AD?
1756 AD.
In 1756 AD, Nawab of Bengal. That is Sirajuddaula. Nawab of Bengal was ruling in West Bengal. So the Britishers, as they have went to Kolkata, they have went to Fort William in Kolkata. So British trade were unhappy of Siraj's thoughtless decision. As Siraj-ud-Daulah, Nawab-e Siraj-ud-Daulah, he was ruling. The Britishers were unhappy. Britishers were unhappy as he was ruling and he is only giving all the orders and that all thing. So Britishers were unhappy with his thoughts. So the British East India Company, what they have done? They have made a wall. What they have done? They have made a wall in Kolkata. What they have done? Wall with some of the security reasons. With some of the security reasons. But they have to take the permission from the Nawab. Nawab has not given them permission. Nawab has not given them permission to build the wall. So Nawab of Bengal has destroyed that wall. Clear this much?
Yes, 1756 AD.
Nawab of Bengal. Who was the Nawab? Siraj-ud-Daulah. Okay. As he was ruling in Bengal, British people were unhappy. So they have made the wall. But Nawab of Bengal has not given the permission. So he has destroyed the wall. So this news, where it reached to the Madras, it reached to Madras, a small British army, under the leadership of Robert Clive. So this news, where it reached to Madras, to the small army. So this news, as it reached, a small army man came to Kolkata. Who came? Robert Clive. To West Bengal to help the Britishers in Bengal. Robert Clive came from Madras to help other British people to open the trade in West Bengal. Clear this much?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear? But this strong army, Clive, defeats the Nawab's army. As Nawab was in opposition, he was not giving the permission. So Robert Clive's army has defeated to whom? Nawab's army. To whom they have defeated? Nawab's army. So who has made now? Secret plan is coming. Clive had made a secret plan with Mir Jafar. With whom they have made a secret plan?
Mir Jafar.
Clive has made a secret plan with Mir Jafar, the commander of chief of Siraj-ud-Daulah, and Sheikh Ami Chand to attack Siraj-ud-Daulah. So Mir Jafar was the commander chief of Siraj-ud-Daulah, and Clive, they made a secret plan to defeat whom? Siraj-ud-Daulah, the Nawab of Bengal. So in 1757 AD, There was a declaration of a war between Siraj-ud-Daulah in the village of Plassey. Where? In the village of Plassey. Which AD? In 1757 AD, there was a war between Britishers and Siraj-ud-Daulah to defeat whom? Siraj-ud-Daulah. At that time, a false means they were wrongly arresting the Siraj-ud-Daulah. Okay, as per the plan, Mir Jafar was not supporting to whom? Siraj-ud-Daulah, as he was with the secret plan with whom? Robert Clive. Yes, so commander chief was not supporting to whom? That is Siraj-ud-Daulah. Right. So that's why a war started in the village of Plassey, which is 38 kilometers far from Murshidabad. And at that time, within a half of day, the war came to an end. Okay, so now what was the result? Mirzapur was made the as Robert Clive was as Mirzapur was supporting to the Robert Clive. So Robert Clive has what done? Robert Clive has made Mirzapur the Nawab of Bengal now. Who made Robert Clive made Mirzapur the Nawab of Bengal after the Battle of Plassey? Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
As Mirzapur became a Nawab of Bengal, as Mirzapur was supporting the British people, so British has controlled 24 Parganas in West Bengal. How many? 24 Parganas. Okay. And it was taken the history of India. It was taken the history of India. Clear how Battle of Plassey started and how it came to the end and what were the reasons.
Yes.
Okay, that this way, step by step, Britishers are coming to India. Clear about this?
Okay,
as in 1556 AD, Nawab of Bengal Siraj-ud-Daula was ruling Bengal. Britishers people were unhappy, so they have made a wall. As they have made a wall, Nawab of Bengal Siraj-ud-Daula, who was ruling in the Bengal, has destroyed the wall. So this news, where it reached to Madras. As it reached to Madras, a small army team of Robert Clive came to Bengal. So at that time, Mirzapur, who was the commander chief of Siraj-ud-Daula, had made a secret plan for a war. So in 1757, in the village of Plassey, 38 km far from Murshidabad in West Bengal, there was a war taken between Siraj-ud-Daula and British. Okay? As after that, Siraj-ud-Daula was defeated. So, the Mirzapur became a Nawab of Bengal. And at that time, 24 Paraganas, 24 districts were taken by whom? By British people, were under the rule of British. So, this way, Battle of Plassey was one of the most important event in the history of India. This way, Britishers came to our India. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Clear.
Next is Battle of Buxar, that we will be learning tomorrow.
Yes, ma'am. Tomorrow. Lecture is
over. That's I'm doing. So tomorrow, today's homework, I will be sending you notes that you have to learn it clearly. Clear.
If not, can I mock also?
After 11 o'clock.
Okay, miss.
Okay, miss.
Okay. Bye, miss. Bye.
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 Be present.
Bye, miss.
Huh?
What? Bye, Kaisha. Bye, Kaisha. Bye.
Ha, beta.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Ah, beta.